Welcome back to your course on object-oriented programming using Java. In this video, we're going to learn about variables. Variables are used to store information to be referenced and manipulated in a computer program. They also provide a way of labeling data with a descriptive name, so our programs can be understood more clearly by the reader and ourselves. It is also helpful to think of variables as containers that hold information, and their sole purpose is to label and store data in the memory. This data can be used throughout your program. So if you talk in a very simplistic manner, there are certain scenarios when the programmer has to create sort of containers which can be used in the future. Okay, so let's say you are creating a program which can add two numbers, but if you create a hard-coded program, it will give predefined values. What will happen is it will always give the same result. But as a programmer, you have to create a general sort of scenario where any given input will give a desired output. So as a programmer, at the point of writing the code, you don't exactly know what the user will input in future. So what you do is you create containers, which are also called as variables in your programs. Once the user runs your program, the variables demand for the input values. They receive the value, they store it in the memory, and they are being used throughout the program. Okay, so in Java there are three types of variables. The first one is local variable. A variable declared inside the class method is called local variable. Okay, so basically anything that you will define inside a function or a method in Java is called a local variable. You're going to use this sort of variable the most. The second one is instance variables. A variable declared inside the class but outside the method is called instance variable, and it is not declared as static. The third one is static variable. A static variable in Java is a variable which belongs to the class and initialized only once at the start of execution. The thing is, you won't be able to understand most of the terms right now at this point of time because you're just beginning with Java. So even if you don't understand what are these three different things, don't worry about that. We're going to create different programs based on these variables, and at that point in time you'll just understand what these variables are. At this point, just understand this, that there are three types of variables: local, instance, and static. And currently the variable that you are going to focus upon is local variable. Okay, so let's see how can we create a local variable in Java. So we are back in IntelliJ IDEA, and I have created a project by the name of OOP in Java, and I have created a Java file by the name of variabledemo.java. And once I have created the file, it has given me some predefined code. Again, since we are just starting with Java, we are not going into the details of what this code exactly is. Instead, what we'll do is we'll just focus on the thing that we are going to do, and that is to define a local variable. Okay, so in Java, you define a local variable using this syntax. The first thing that you do is you write the data type. It may be int, it may be byte, it may be short, float, or any other data type that you know. Okay, so let's say I want to create a number which can hold the age of a user. Okay, the second thing that I would like to say is that whenever you create variable names, just make sure the names are descriptive. It enhances the code readability of your program. So let's say if I want to store the age of the user in a variable, this is how I'll do it. I'll write, or I'll specify the data type of the variable, which is int in my case. Then I'll keep a name for the variable. Let's say the name of the variable is age underscore user, or even better, it can be kept as user underscore age. Okay. So this is how you declare a variable. You just write the data type and you just write the name of the variable. And this is how you initialize a variable. You just use the equal to operator and you just initialize with a value. So currently the age of the current user is 27. Okay. And now this is how you use it. Let's say I have to print it out on the screen. So I'll just call the system out.print function, and I'll just provide the variable over here. Okay, so now if I run this value, run this code, and you can see that the value has been printed. Okay, so now if I want to change it to something else, I can do it easily. I'll just run it again and you can see the value has been changed. Similarly, you can define different types of variables. Let's say I want to store the name of the user. So let's say the name is Rahul, and instead of age, I'll just print out the name. Okay, so now if I run the code, this should print the second variable, that is user underscore name. Here it is. Okay, so guys, variables are really important in programming and in Java too. So just make sure you try and write this code, okay, and just be comfortable with variables. And currently we have just discussed how to create and use a local variable, but in the further videos we are also going to discuss about the instance variables and the static variables. Thank you.